Hey, what's going on, my advocate and viewers? My name is PGPYT, welcome back to the channel, and today we're talking about why arcade games matter to advocate. Now, let me first of all preference by saying, at the time of me making this video, there's only four arcade games available, arcade collections available to purchase, as well as them announcing two more coming later this year. Basically, right guys, to me, these games matter a lot of collectors, a lot of consumers of advocate, because we want to play those arcade games again. Now, looking at the lineup we've got here, I've got all four of the arcade cartridges so far, so Technos, Data East, Galico, and Atari. If you want my honest opinion, the ones that are the best out of these four, if I had to rank them, I'd rank them Technos, Data East, Galico, Atari. Literally, the way they line up here, because that's just the kind of guy I am. I prefer beat 'em ups, so you know, having beat 'em ups on Technos, which is great to me, and playing these games portable is amazing. Now, why this is a big deal is because a lot of these arcade games you can't find anymore. A lot of these cabinets, you know, are relatively expensive to purchase if you want to own one outright, even if you want to get one from Arcade 1-Up, it's quite expensive if they even do these games. And a lot of these games are more obscure and harder to find in some cases when it comes to companies like Galico, because they kind of spun off that whole division. And they don't even make games anymore, so that's a big thing we've got to remember. When it comes to Evercade, you know, Cade's in the name, Arcade is in the name, you know. So when Evercade first launched back in 2020, and there was no arcade games on the platform, it left a sour taste in some consumers' mouths because it was just NES games and whatnot. Now, don't get me wrong, a lot of the games they had were great. But these are the better versions of some of those games. And that's why these matter to a lot of consumers. Because, you know, consumers want the real games. They want the real deal. So when they start announcing arcade collections, people forget, oh, yes, you know, we're getting arcade games. And so far, they've done quite well. You know, the games they've offered, you know, three of them, well, four, all four of them technically, are from companies that already, you know, had deals with Blaze to release games on Evercade. And we are getting two more basically, from what we know, we should be getting like five more arcade cartridges this year, I think. It's four or five or something like that. And two of the ones we know we're getting is Galico 2 and Jalico. Now, I'm impressed for saying this. Jalico looks like a great one I want to get. You know, the Japanese developer with, you know, some great looking shoot 'em ups. And then Galico 2 just kind of looks kind of meh to me. I'm going to get it to complete the collection, obviously. But none of the games are really massive draws for me. But I just want to have that collection in my collection, just so I have the complete set. Now, also, what you've got to remember with a lot of these games is Technos and Data East are bundled with Evercade VS. So, if you want to experience these games, you could buy a VS console. You have a console, you have these games, you've got 18 games an hour out of the box. If you get the premium pack, you know, it's quite worthwhile, depending on, you know, if what games interest you, you know, and what your tastes are when it comes to gaming. Now, obviously, we're going to see more companies come to Evercade. We're going to see more arcade companies, you know, license their games to Evercade. And some people want some of the big ones like Williams, Midway, Sega, Capcom, SNK, Konami, Taito, all these big names. And I'll be honest, I wouldn't be opposed to any of those. Right? I think getting some of these games, you're getting like R-Type or King of Fighters or Space Invaders, would be massive draws for consumers to jump onto Evercade. However, what you've got to remember, guys, is the bigger these companies are, the more expensive those rights are going to be. And Blaze is a small company. Blaze is a tiny company. And we know Evercade sells, is probably selling quite well, because they keep announcing games for it. They keep being able to make these deals for these new cartridges and these new collections, as well as, you know, having two different consoles that you can buy, whether it be the handheld or VS. I mean, just me alone. Yeah, I own both the handheld and the VS. I own all the cartridges. I own extra controllers for the VS. You know, I know that Blaze probably made quite a pretty penny off of consumers like myself. It just comes down to, you know, if Blaze can sign a deal, if they can negotiate a good enough deal. Because we could have gotten arcade versions of Namco games, for instance. But obviously, the deals Blaze had with Namco have now expired. So, we're probably not going to get arcade games from Namco. Which to me is kind of disappointing, because I wouldn't mind playing Tekken on Evercade. you know, I think getting more fighting games in general on Evercade would be a huge draw to many consumers. Because for the Evercade VS, a lot of the multiplayer games or games that are capable of multiplayer are mostly like sports titles and racing games and beat 'em ups. Which, if you want to play an actual fighting game, you've got a few options. There's like three fighting games in total on Evercade. Two of them are Clay Fighter, so, you know, it is what it is. But to me, I think Arcade matters greatly to Evercade, and it will matter to Evercade greatly in the future, because think about it this way. Blaze needs more games on Evercade, games that are going to attract a new audience and attract consumers to purchase Evercade, right? And they can do that with Arcade games, you know, being one of the only consoles, all the consoles can be Arcade games, but being able to actually purchase some of these more obscure Arcade games from Japanese developers, Spanish developers, wherever they are in the world, could be a huge get for many consumers who want to play some Arcade games again, you know, want to re-experience their childhoods, or, you know, they just want to collect them. So that's just me. To me, obviously, I didn't grow up around arcades. I was born in 2003, so by the time I was born, basically, most arcades were closing down, you know, arcades were dying, slowly dying out, because you had this like the sixth generation of consoles, I think it was, with Xbox entering the arena, Sega just pulled out, PlayStation 2 was coming out, GameCube was coming out, you know, well, they'll have been out for years, and was really leading up to Xbox 360, PS3, and Wii. So, you know, there's that weird era sort of thing where a lot of these arcade companies kind of just started to slowly fizzle out. And as they fizzled out, you know, it'd be nice if Blaze is able to get some of their games, if it's possible, to preserve them on these cartridges and make them available to new consumers, new players. Or, you know, even just old gamers who enjoy these games when they were younger, when they were kids, and when, you know, they want to experience them again. Anyway, guys, let me know what you think. Do you think arcade games matter to Evercade? You know, let me know in the comments down below what you think. Make sure you like, share, subscribe. I've been PGP. I'll catch you next episode. Peace.